Hello everyone, and welcome back to Anne's Book Reviews, or Book Reviews with Anne, whatever you choose. So today, for my romance novel, I am going to do the Sheik, or Sheik, I think hope I'm not completely butchering that, and The Princess in Waiting by Susan Mallery. So usually I'm not a big fan of the small romance novels like this one. But this one was actually pretty fun. So with real quick for the age of this book, it's from 2004. And it is, for any disclaimers in it, because I don't completely know about all cultures out there, if there is a book that has something that I feel like I'm not super familiar with the culture, I try to just pretend that it is a pretend planet and it is not based in real life. This one doesn't have anything that's, like no slurs or anything like that, but I don't know how familiar the writer is with this culture, so I try to keep that in mind whenever I'm reading it and don't just like, oh yeah, that's totally how, you know, that culture runs. So just as that as a disclaimer, because sometimes whenever I read books from one person to another, I just don't know how much they know about the culture. Sometimes I really think it's nice if a author will include where they got their research from, and like I've read a few Native American novels that have where they got their resources from and how they're knowledgeable about that specific tribe or something. So that, for instance, so I don't know anything about this culture. So just saying that from the get-go, I just pretend I'm like, oh, it's, you know, fake and fantasy and somewhere that's not real. And if you do that, then this can be a pretty enjoyable story, I think. I got this guy. I know for sure I got this guy for free. So I have friends of mine that know that I really love romance novels and books. And so sometimes they will send me, I know they're amazing, amazing friends. Sometimes they will send me books. I will get boxes of books, and it's my personal favorite because there's all sorts of stuff in the books. Books in the box. And there used to be used bookstores that did the same thing. They had like a brown bag special, and you could just pay like 10 bucks and get a bag, and who knows what's in it. And I think that's a ton of fun. I haven't found very many around here or in New Orleans that did that, but in Missouri there used to be a couple. So this one I got from a friend of mine that sent me a box of books, and so I got this for free. If you go on Thrift Books, which everybody has heard me talk about Thrift Books, if you haven't, you can check out their website or their app, and if you order so many books, then you start to get, you know, points and free books if you become a member. And you don't have to pay anything, obviously, except for your books. And if you're in the United States, if you order books over $10, the shipping is free. Which if you get a lot of books, that is a good thing. So this guy on Thrift Books is $4.69. On Barnes & Noble, this is $4.99. And Amazon, for Kindle, it's $4.99. And paperback is $6.87. And usually the shipping for Amazon is $3.99. I need to look on Barnes & Noble and see what their shipping is, just so you have a heads up. So real quick, like I said, and the lust meter is a 4 on this guy. They do talk about sex, they do talk about virginity and wanting each other, but I don't feel like they go into it deep like they do in some other romance novels. So a little bit, not a lot, which I think is really common with these little romance novels. Like I said, these aren't usually like my number one favorite go-to, but there were 9 pages. This author had 9 pages on Thrift Books of these little romance novels. And usually the man is well off and the woman will, be a nanny or a maid or something. Or this one, they were, college sweethearts, and something where she comes in contact with someone that is unknowingly a millionaire and will fall in love, and then, you know, he helps take care of her or something, and they get married and they have children happily ever after. I saw a ton of hers also that had to do with kids and pregnancies, which I'm not sure if anybody out there, if you are looking for romance novels and you're not looking really for erotica or the fighting like I like the tipping between the two. If you like really just a traditional, almost, it reminds me of the Hallmark Channel. The Hallmark Channel kind of romance novels. If you're looking for something like that, just a really sweet romance novel that you would see on Christmas on Hallmark, go for Susan Mallery, because it very much is, a little adventure. Like I said, it didn't get a sticker from me just because it wasn't one that I would read a lot, but I thought it was a fun story. So pretty much the synopsis is that they met in college, they fell in love, and they got married. And then she didn't really see him again. And so she assumed that their marriage was null and void because it happened in the Caribbean. And so she was really surprised whenever she was summoned and he was actually a prince. And the king said before he annulled their marriage that he wanted to meet her and he needed 2 weeks to get to know her before he, you know, finalized the annulment. And of course they're having difficulties because they actually love each other, but they won't tell each other. And so you get to see that awesome adventure unfold. I think it's worth a read depending on what kind of romance novel you like. To me personally, I think there is a little bit of man-manning in there, but I think most romance novels have that. And so I just kind of read it with a grain of salt and hope that the girl kind of gets back at him in her own personal way of like, oh, whatever. And I think she does. I think she gives pretty well here after the initial, oh, sorry, cat, no. So after the initial, you know, surprise or whatever. So, where was I saying? Cat, you distracted me. Worse than the children. So yes, I think it was fun if that's the kind of romance novel you want to read. Like I said, low erotica, lots of love, lots of gushiness. And children. And if you want to get her other collections, like I said, she has a ton. She had like one for Texas and she had one for Millionaire. She had a couple that were like pregnant, the pregnant princess and stuff. And then also this series is a series. I did not know that. Thank you again for doing book reviews because otherwise I would never know. There is, I think maybe 13 in this series. So there's a ton of them. So good news is if you do like it, you have plenty more to read. And I saw on Amazon that they had a bulk set, but I didn't specifically look for the bulk set and that one was unavailable. So you might have to just kind of look it up. So if that's your cup of tea, give it a try. It's cute, it's adorable, and it's tiny. So if you're a book reader, avid book reader, this wouldn't take you any time at all. You'd have this finished in the evening. If you started, you know, before bed, I bet you could finish this. But if you started at 9 o'clock, like when you put everybody else to bed and lay down, I bet you'd finish this before like 11. It'd be easy. But it would be a fun little enjoyable thing to go to sleep to. So hopefully you like that one. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, you want me to go deeper into this one or any of the other books that I have done reviews on, please let me know in the comments below. And if there's any books that you would like me to do a review on, please let me know. So yes, again, boop, check it out. If you want, if that's your cup of tea, if not, go ahead and pick up a different book. So have a good day. And we'll see you all soon.